Selling them high jibbing, tending to my pimping. Time slipping, late, I'm on my way. Enough hours in a day to be Dre. I'm El Presidente. I run things, tow gun things, and never run from things. Braveheart, but I'm not Mel Gibson. I'm dope like coke that was cooked in the kitchen. Dabbing revolution, stabbing, and I'm loosing. Mini me laptops, mini beats that knock. Lots of hemp, lobster, not shrimp. Big perms, baby, I pimp on, baby. Always shopping, no more hall mopping. Hella nights with Gucci, hella nights with Gucci.
Tell baby, play cash, but be friendly. Ghost on them, after your host on them. She a team player, I play coach on them. Like a doobie in a jerk, play roach on them. Won't smoke on them if it ain't down, la 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 la. Lots of notes on them, C status. Won't holler till it's G status. I'm cut though, 3C savage. Whatever me want, me haven't seen me lavish. Your trash might be cash, give me that bitch. Like little mama in labor, I push puss. That's real talk, all's real talk, cuz cuz.
Hold on, let me finish sharing this, cause I told them I was gonna get a link.
To this day, won't love, won't get paid. And for you, get a song like a bitch thing.
Now I can talk a bitch brain out of noggin and slide across being nice like toboggans. Wizard be a fool for we get the smiling. Bitch quit sobbing, get a trick dick robbing. Now you can be a sidekick like Batman or Robin. No all-star pimp shit, that beat got her robbing. Her head don't stop, I she keep on nodding. And all I do is collect and sell the product. I knock a fake watch, bitch dipped in Prada. And still check all of it, every dollar. And I don't even call, but they hear me holler. And get a bitch train to run game on scholar. Get it for your father, don't even bother. A bitch circus overload, I don't stop her. Bitch now stop, hold up, robotic. And every piece of dough that bitch touch, I got it.
Give me a second, we're getting ready to get started. I'm just sharing this right quick, making sure everybody don't have no excuse. You didn't share the link. You didn't share the link. I missed it. Hold on, I'm about to get to everybody. Before the message, I'm gonna answer some questions that was put in my DM. Hold on, let me find something else to play.
Selling a home is a huge hassle. Open door knock.
Hold on. Just give me 1 second. I'm gonna share it to that simple page.
Typed in my address.
And we're gonna get things cracking. I haven't forgot about them spiritual questions that y'all been asking too. I'm gonna get to it. I'm gonna get to it. Trust me, I am. Hold on. Here we go. Hold on.
You know why, right?
Rock the jewelry with the clear stones. Get on the nigga head like some headphones. Up in the spirit with a clear tone. Get your attention. The biggest thing's just the TV invention. Dope is all off. A big shot to show off. Plus I'm a big pimp. I get toe off. Fuckers get job. She need a good job. I sell BJs till her mouth get raw. I'm from the California coast. Beaches and bridges. If the cop get ghost, I'll be sleeping with bitches. I got a cool nut. Sitting on wires, on foes, bitch, not Michelin tires. Can't control my desires. I fight for Nordstrom's, not Fred Myers. I do a lot of weed, love my suppliers. You keep it, fuck the blood, out my supplier. Man, I'm bigger than life. I do it magnum. I like these dope bitches, I'm doing it having them. Trey Bogart, you shove any push. Start a war for nothing like G.W. Bush. We be loving the clutch, but only in the backwood. Out of backwood, we ain't all that good. I'm from the streets where most need heat, but I slice a nigga up like roast beef meat.
I can ask some questions on YouTube. Anything else? Pimp for you? Not my job. I can give you some game, but I can't pimp for you. Not my job. I make some videos, but answering all the questions in DM, not my job.
I make it smile, but anything else?
Wait, hold on.
She gon' ask me to come with her to the grocery shop.
What the fuck? Like this. No, sorry, that's not my job. I don't do that. I'm a pimp slash pimp. I thought you knew that. Man, that's my shit. I'll be all day listening to some Mac Dre. Better watch myself. One boss move.
You can stop thyself. Sometimes I'm not myself.
Hold on.
I'm another man. I'm a rock star.
And another band.
Plus, I'm the man with the plan in his hands.
Alright, cool.
We all playing sand.
Rest in peace to Mac Dre. And blessings to the Bay Area. Let me sit up there. Matter of fact, I'll just go to my phone. See what I done missed. See what y'all saying. Not just Mac Dre, but Jay Diggs too. But niggas just be throwing Jay Diggs under the bus. I remember somebody was just throwing somebody over Jay Diggs. Like, Jay Diggs ain't got slaps. Jay Diggs got slaps too. One of my favorite songs by Jay Diggs is Now You Want Your Nigga Back. That's my favorite song. That's what you play for these bitches. Now You Want Your Nigga Back. Okay, let me see what y'all say. Let me go to the very top. What's going on, Ant? What's up with you, bro? Jess, I'm glad that you finally made it to the live, man. Blessings to you. Charles, blessings, man. Prodigy, yeah, that's my shit. Yeah, I know, man, too. Saying I need that video on how to end. Bro, you have been waiting patiently. I ain't lying. God damn. I just wanted to make it special, bro. I wanted to make the interview just as special as the strip club. But if I can't do it the way that I want to do it, see, that's just me. That's just the way that I feel about this pimping. When I do a video, or just like if I was to do an album or a mixtape about the pimping, I wouldn't take as long as Dr. Dre, but I'm not a nigga to just throw shit together, man. I want you to feel the quality. I want to have the substance and intelligence of the game. It got to be delivered right. I don't want to sit back and be like, God damn, I should have did this or I should have did that. I don't just throw shit together. I ain't saying a nigga going to be taking 1,000 years to do something, but, you know, like how a pimp should conduct himself in the strip club. Like I said, I wanted pimps. I wanted people from all angles, because you got niggas from Miami that's in Miami right now that's balling like a motherfucker, that's driving that Phantom, that's in that Wraith, that's in a damn, you know what I mean, a 7-8 bedroom house. So if you in a 7-8 bedroom house and you paid a stripper, or you went to the boom boom room or whatever the fuck they call it back in the, you know, because I ain't never did it. But, you know what I mean, whatever they call it back there or whatever, and you came up on a stripper through tricking, you're not really going to listen to Sin. You're not going to listen to me. Sin going to tell you don't pay that bitch. Sin going to tell you keep your money in your pocket. But at the same time, some niggas actually believe in more than compliments to get a development. Some niggas will actually give away money that they got from the pavement to get a development. Niggas will sit up there and give a bitch a dick preview, a money preview, just to get a motherfucking interview out of a bitch. So with that being said, everybody's opinion, everybody's perspective is not my perspective. So like I said, when I give my perspective, I'm giving my perspective, and yes, there are a lot of P's that are in agreement with me, but you got niggas with rings and chains on and beautiful cars and houses, and the way that they got it was making it rain on the bitch. Or, you know, some of them ate pussy. Some of them actually, you know, got a bitch pregnant. And just because, you know, the outcome turned into some income, they can't listen to the knowledge and wisdom that I'm conveying. They can't hear it simply because they looking at the materialistics instead of looking at the characteristics on how a P should be. You know what I mean? So that's why I wanted, you know, I didn't want to just be the typical sinful video where I'm just giving my perspective. I wanted, just like you see debates in the conscious community, you know what I mean, with motherfuckers going back and forth. I wanted three representatives to represent basically my perspective, and I wanted three representatives on the other side saying, fuck what Sinful talking about, you know what I mean? Nigga, I'm in the S550 in the motherfucking coupe. Yeah, you know, I ate the bitch ass, I ate her pussy, I sucked the motherfucking toes, but I got a bankroll out them hoes. You know what I'm saying, nigga? And I'm about to buy another rose. You know what I mean? That's the type of what I want, because it's gonna bring energy. It's gonna basically generate, you know what I mean, the right amount of views for it, because that's a topic that's so, it could be real big, because that strip club is another world. So that's why I didn't want it to be the typical Sinful the P video where I got some music playing and it's just me talking. I wanted to have everything set up. You know, I was gonna have some real pimps that's authentic and really in it, and then I was gonna have them niggas that think they authentic and really in it just because they got some money out of it. You know what I mean? So that's the way I wanted it to do it. But because the information is just so valuable, if I can't hurry up and get it the way I then I do something. But that's the way I wanted it to be done. As far as the interview, bro, I might can put it in simplicity and put it in like a 30-minute, maybe an hour video. But bro, it's so many valid points for the interview video that shit could take up to like 2 to 3 hours. You know what I mean? Especially when you got other pimps, you know what I mean, that's chopping game up. So, you know what I mean? But you have waited, and I appreciate you for waiting, bro. You have waited on me to do that. It was a question that was asked in my DM. Sinful, how you feel about pimps getting married? And I'm going to tell you this. Before he's a pimp, he is a man. And like I said, my opinion don't have any dominion over anybody, you know. So let's just say, okay, if a guy decides to not be active in the game anymore, if he decides to get married, I don't have nothing against him. I'm not going to minimize him or say that he's any less of a P just because he said I do. Now, me personally, I'm 33 years old. I could never see myself getting married. And the reason why I say that, even if I wasn't in the game, I wouldn't see myself getting married because of the type of individual I am. And see, that's why it's hard for me. I need to speak to the P's who have left the game. And see, I've spoken to different retired P's who are married. And they told me personally, you know, one of the worst things that they ever did would stop pimping. Then I got some other P's to say one of the worst things they ever did was get married to a square. It wasn't so much that they stopped pimping. It's just that when they stopped pimping, they got involved with a square, and maybe P Money was funny at the time because he wasn't saving money. You know what I mean? Niggas like to glorify themselves and they forget about the saving money part. And once it's over, you know what I mean? The game don't want them no more. They old, and you know what I mean? He called a square that was financially able to put him in position and be a blessing to him, had good credit. So that's how a bitch basically sometime can get a motherfucker to walk down the miles and make it. But that's some strong shit. You made a covenant to God with the bitch. That's some strong shit, man. But I wanted to actually ask the P's, like, you know, how do you do that? How do you go from a lifestyle for living decades? You know what I mean? Some P's 10 years, some 15, some 20, but some, I'm talking about 30, 40 years of having multiple women do what you want, when you want, how you want. Don't back talk, don't out talk. Sit up there and motherfucking comply and apply to everything that you convey and say. And to go from that to actually having some type of like equality thing, getting off your throne and, you know, and then getting on your knees, proposing and all of that type, like how you, I don't know. I could never see Sinful the Masterpiece Mouthpiece P getting on his knees and proposing to a woman for her to be his wife. I can't see it. I'm not going to say it's never going to happen, but I'm just speaking as I'm not God. But right now with my mentality, you know what I mean? I can't see that. Even if I wasn't Sinful the P, Philip Gilmore, Philip Brandon Gilmore, I can't see that. just the type of individual I am. And just putting pimps to the side, I've even spoken to some ministers because they knew me when I was about that life, when I was spiritual. And they even told me, like, son, when you come back to the ministry, when you come back on fire for God, don't even, you know what I mean? If you do, you do, but don't even, like, you had a lot of fun in the world. Don't even come back worrying about being married and stuff like that. Because I done seen a lot of great ministers who were great preachers, and once they got married, it was like they lost that fire. So, you know, to each his own. You can't judge the whole population. There are some people that are married, they're happily married, they're successful, and I, you know, that's what's up. But as far as me, I don't think that he's any less of a P, and I don't think that minimizes his legacy just because, you know, he decided to be with a woman. Hopefully, in my eyes, I would hope that he would want to marry a hoe, somebody who basically been putting their life in danger and seducing and reducing strangers each and every motherfucking night, making sure that his money was right. A woman who basically got into a continuity of giving that nigga loyalty and currency on the daily for a number of years. That's the woman that I would hope that somebody who said that they were a pimp was to marry, because there's going to be certain trials and tribulations and situations where she's not even going to be able to understand you unless she comes from the game. So if she don't come from the game, you know, the words that you speak is going to be another vernacular. And as I like to say, it's going to be too spectacular for the bride to even understand. So I don't know how they do it, but they doing it, you know, and it is what it is. Let me get back, see what you guys are saying. That's how I feel about marriage. I don't think that, hold on. You know, I don't think that he's any less of a P. I do believe that. Now, let me say this. If you are an active pimp, no active pimp should be married. No active pimp should be married. If you are an active, well, if you're professing to be an active pimp and you have made a covenant with God, with a bride, and you got prostitutes and things like that, nigga, you living a double life. An active pimp ain't got no business with no motherfucking girlfriend. He ain't got no business with no motherfucking wife. You know what I'm saying? Pimping and hoeing is supposed to be his life. And only pimping and hoeing. That's it. He ain't got no business sitting over there, you know what I mean, licking and lapping with girlfriends on the motherfucking weekend. And on the weekend, I mean, on weekdays, he getting dividends, you know what I mean, from prostitute girlfriends. He need to move and step the fuck out of the way and let pimping have his way. You know what I mean? That's the problem with niggas now. Getting in shit they ain't got no business. Hold on. Let me see what y'all saying. And let me say this too. You know, I've seen so many people, you know, speak about how they came into the game, and I'm gonna speak about that as well, you know, in this message. But you know, a lot of the people's introductions is weak as fuck. You know what I mean? You niggas be like, so they be like, so why you start pimping? Oh man, my wife treated me bad. You know, my wife cheated on me, or my girlfriend left. You know what I mean? Or my dog died. Nigga, that's why you started pimping, because a bitch did you wrong. Oh, so you just a woman scorned, and you said you just about to do a bitch bad because they've been doing you bad. Oh, no, you know, that's not a good introduction, man, in this motherfucking pimping, man. You know what I mean? Just keeping that thing all the way, you know what I mean, 100, man, you know? But you got people that will sit up there and say that. They will actually sit up there and tell you that they came into this game because, you know, they got into it with their wife, or a divorce, or she sat up there and took the kids and left me. So because she took the kids and left and the dog, you said, you know what? I'm through with this shit. No more. Y'all not. So you sat up there and played the waiting to exhale. Hold on. That nigga said, I'm going to tell you what you niggas sound like when you do that. I'll be like, look at these niggas, man. Talking about they pimps. Listen to a nigga's introductions into the game. You know, after she did me wrong, man, I just couldn't take it no more. you know, that's when I was like, you know what? I'm about to go pimp. Hold on. I'm going to tell you what you niggas be sounding like. When I hear a nigga tell me, when he say that he got out of the game, he came in the game, excuse me. He came into the game because his girlfriend cheated on him or his wife left him, you know what I mean, and all of this shit, you know what I mean? I instantly, in my mind, I started laughing. I was like, look at this old worn woman, the scoring ass nigga. He's a woman scoring inside of a man's body talking about he just pimping. This is exactly what I be hearing. This is exactly what I be hearing when you niggas be sitting up there talking about some... Hold on, let me get to the chorus. Niggas be like, I'm not gonna cry. You know, man? Hold on. Niggas make up their mind. I'm not gonna cry. That's it. I'm about to go pimp. Look, man, you can't do this pimping like that. And I know y'all bringing up Sugar Free's name, man. I seen that interview, man. You know, and I ain't gonna really say nothing negative about Sugar Free, because Sugar Free done gave, you know what I mean, the soundtrack to niggas that sending hoes and pimping bitches on the track. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, his shit been good. But I ain't gonna lie, when Sugar Free said the shit that he was saying, that's all I heard. I was like, I was like, what the fuck? Niggas be like, they be having the one finger up. Hey, niggas be having that one finger up. You know what ugly motherfuckers be singing and shit? Got the one finger up, one finger on the stomach, and eyes closed. You know what I mean? Oh, I'm not gonna cry to P-ass niggas. But, hold on. But yeah, man, you know what I mean? If you want to be a pimp just because your dog, because the bitch took the dog and she divorced you and all that suck-ass shit, you not this pimping, man. You just a woman scoring inside of a man's body, man. Knock it off. Stop that. All right, let me see what y'all saying, man. Hold on. I was in the crib. Yeah, bro. Niggas be hurt. They be like, man, I'm about to get into the game. I'm about to get into the game. Hold on. How I started being a player called cheating. Yeah. They always be saying that sucker ass shit. She left me, man, and it was like, you know what I mean? That's it. You know what I mean? You cheated on me for the last motherfucking time. I'm sick of this shit. I'm about to go pimp. No, I don't want to hear it. I'm about to go pimp. I'm about to go pimp. Like, and then one thing that I hate is when I see a nigga say that he retired, say that he leaving the game, and then he go get a girlfriend, he booed up on Facebook, you know what I mean? He kissy poo to pee. You can tell, or he taking pictures where the bitch got her feet in his face. He got toes in his face. He posting that on Instagram. He making motherfucking hot dog sandwiches and shit for kids that ain't even his motherfucking kids. You know what I mean? He's smiling and shit. He at church with the bitch. You know what I mean? He teaching Sunday school now. And once the relationship turned into a battleship, now he want to bring his old raggedy ass back to this motherfucking pimping, man, and be on some like, okay, where was I? No, nigga, that ain't how this shit go. It ain't no motherfucking where was I, nigga? You know what I mean? So, hold on. Oh, that's the bitch. But, you know what I mean? It ain't no motherfucking where was I, nigga? Niggas be sitting over there making hot dogs for kids, for bastards that ain't bastard-ass kids that ain't even his, man. You know what I mean? Taking care, smiling this shit all on IG. You know what I mean? All on Twitter. Then when the relationship don't work, now he back on Fig. Now he back on Sepulveda. Now he want to come back to Sunset. Now he all in Vegas and shit. Now, I hate it when you niggas say shit like, yeah, man, you know what I mean? I was married for 7 years. Then after the, I tried to be a husband, right? You know what I'm saying? I was a faithful motherfucking husband and shit, you know, but the bitch just didn't know how to treat a pimp, man. You know, I had to realize that being a boyfriend, that shit wasn't me. It wasn't me, P. You know what I mean? So the marriage didn't work because it wasn't me. You know what I'm saying? So that's the reason why the marriage didn't work, because, you know what I mean, I'm a pimp, man. You know, I had to just realize that the God called me to be a pimp, and I had to get divorced, man. I had to motherfucker get divorced, man. You know what I mean? For real, though, man. That's why I'm down and about it, you know what I'm saying, right now. And it's like, nigga, no. You was never the motherfucking pimping, nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that. See, this is my personal belief. I believe that a pimp, a true pimp, you know what I'm saying, anointed and appointed by the game pimp, he never really stopped using the game. If that nigga turned into a preacher, if that nigga turned into a teacher, a motivational speaker, it, whatever profession, you know, that he decide, he might go into spirituality. Reality is, he can't leave this game alone. It's in his veins, nigga. Even if he receives salvation and go to step two, sanctification. Hey, man, the information that he got from this occupation called pimping and hoeing is still going to be in the location of his motherfucking mind. So he's still going to use this game, man. This game is going to be used all his motherfucking life. A true pimp, a real pimp that come from the game, ain't going to never stop using this game. Even if he not active, he going to use this game to the day that he die, because it's in him. It's just in him, man. It's in him to use the game. A real P. So when you see a nigga and, you know, he went from smashing the P, I go hard on the bitch the P, I go hard on hoes the Mac, and next time you see him, you know what I mean, he got some old stank ass bitch with her big ass thighs and shit hanging out some shorts, and she got her feet all in his face and shit, and he talk, and the caption at the bottom on Instagram say, chilling with Bang. Chilling on the weekend with Bang. On the couch with Bang. He went from, wait a minute, stop. You went from campaigning and getting their bitches on feed. You went from sitting over there being on the E14. You sit up there, you understand me, was knocking hoes on Cicero. You was sitting over there, you understand me, campaigning and motherfucking turning out bitches in Sacramento. You know what I mean? Sitting over there, you understand me, knocking bitches left and motherfucking right. And now tonight, you her bae? Chilling with bae? Oh, no, man. You know what I mean? And that shit really kills me. It makes me want to throw up, because you never was this pimping. And then you got these bitches who really don't have the right definition, vision, depiction of this motherfucking shit. You know what I'm saying? And when she see you professing to be this shit, and she judging somebody like me or another P by the motherfucking abominable shit that you doing. You know what I mean? Like, man, that shit is disgusting. But getting right into this motherfucking message, man. You know what I mean? Because I was chopping it up with one of my young P partners. I know he already watching it. Yeah, beta P ass niggas. It's a whole population of beta P ass niggas. I ain't gonna lie. Beta P ass niggas is winning in 2017. These bitches, as one of my P partners said, most of them really don't want no pimp. A lot of these bitches really just want a cool ass, hip, fly ass, hip boyfriend that's just comfortable with her being a motherfucking square prostitute. Real talk, that's all she want. She just want a nigga to eat her ass, eat the shit crumbs that come out her motherfucking booty hole, accept her little bankroll, and be comfortable with her being a prostitute. That's it. She really don't want to sit up there and be a hoe, and she really don't want to fuck with a pimp. She just want an Oscar award winning role as if basically she the real thing. That's all. These bitches just want to feel important. When y'all realize that these bitches really just want to feel important, you're going to pimp so much better. You're going to be like, damn. Why? It was just that simple. They really just want to feel important. That's all. They want to feel important, man. That's all. A bitch really don't give a damn about no motherfucking money, man. It's all about feeling important. They want to feel a part of something. You know what I'm saying? Now, they do need some game. You know what I mean? But, you know, let me say this, because my partner was like, man, I don't know what's wrong. You know, this bitch done blew up on me, you know what I mean, five times. you know what I mean, P, within like 3 weeks. I'm like, God damn, nigga, and you accepted it 5 times? I said, each time when the bitch blew up, you know what I mean, what happened? You know, you didn't charge the bitch? See, a lot of you niggas, you know what I mean, is getting, you know, insults and negative motherfucking results because the way you be letting these bitches come back through the door, man. That bitch was supposed to come back right. She was supposed to come back with that bankroll. You know what I'm saying? When Lucifer got kicked out of heaven, did God let him come back? No. That's how you gotta look at your pimping. Like, bitch, it was heaven with me. You know what I mean? So, you know, just allowing a bitch to just come back because she pretty or she got a ass that's big enough to fuck up a toilet. Nigga, fuck that. Fuck that. To all my young P partners, you niggas is fly, you young, you in your youth, you know what I mean? A lot of these older niggas is hating on you because you young, you fly. Some of y'all is, you know what I mean, you're in shape, you're handsome, you know what I mean? Yeah, some of y'all don't have no kids. Some of y'all got the nerve to have some good credit. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got no, man, you don't gotta put up with that shit. You know what I mean? I'm taking the time out to tell you young peas, man, you important. You the definition of important. You ain't got to deal with none of that shit. You know what I mean? Look in that mirror, nigga, and look at the artwork of God. Look in that mirror, nigga, and look at the definition of a blessing. Look in that mirror, nigga, and look at the definition of a walking miracle, nigga. You ain't got to accept none of that shit. So, you know, getting into it, though, man, he was like, man, and this is what caught me off guard. Because we didn't have so many conversations, I just thought that this information was common, but a lot of you niggas really don't know. You know what I mean? Some of you niggas is really trying to pimp with your dick. Some of you niggas is really trying to pimp with your dick. And all my people are these squares, they don't know. They just enjoying entertainment. But for all of the representatives, man, make sure you like this and share this because I want other young representatives to definitely see this video. So share it on Facebook. You know what I mean? Definitely like, and after this live video go off, get in the comment section, man, and let me know what you like. Give your input as well. But, you know, he was like, man, I don't know, you know, what happened. You know what I mean? I dicked it down. I'm listening to him. I'm like, dicked it down? You know, like, he said, I dicked it down. This one really caught me. He said, I fucked her in pocket. I said, fuck her in pocket? You fucked her in pocket. Nigga, what you mean you fucked her in pocket? I was like, whoa, you fucked her in pocket. Boy, you young niggas is crazy, man. You know what I mean? You'll make somebody 33 feel like they 73, man. You fucked the bitch in pocket. Okay, so I said, I'm listening. He said, man, listen to me, P. So he said, you know what I mean? I fucked the bitch in pocket, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, I put it down. And he said, and I ain't gonna lie, because I let all my young niggas know, man, you could be yourself with me. I don't look down on you. Like I taught y'all in time past. You got other peas that's gonna say what they gonna say. But I told you, me myself, even if I wasn't in the game, I wouldn't be eating no pussy. That's just my preference, all right? As a man. But if it's your preference, if you like eating pussy, if that's the way that you like pleasing your woman, nigga, then that's the way that you like pleasing your woman. Nigga, what you doing in the bedroom, that's on you. Now, me personally, I don't think that's pimpish. You know what I mean? Me personally, I don't think that's really clean, man, to be sitting over there kissing your mama or kissing your motherfucking kids, nigga, and you sitting over there eating and lapping on that pussy. But I mean, hey, if you want to take your anointed mouthpiece, if you want to take the instrument of God, if you want to take God's microphone, if you want to take the game's microphone and sit up there and take that same tongue that you give anointed and profound instructions and take that same tongue and stick it in the sewer of a bitch, then that's what the fuck you do, nigga. That's on you. But as far as Sinful The P, I can't do it, baby. But he's into that. So, you know, he thought that after eating the pussy and after the bitch riding his face and jumping on his face and making the pussy bounce up and down on his face and, you know what I mean, tasting the world and shit, you know, I like to say it, tasting the world, because even, let me say this to you squares and shit too, because y'all gonna sit up there and laugh, eating a whole pussy? Yeah, nigga, and some of you motherfuckers that's in relationship with girlfriends, is taking more dick than a lot of these motherfucking hoes out here. You know what I mean? So just keeping that shit 100, you really ain't no different. So you really shouldn't be looking down on no man that's sitting over there tasting the motherfucking hoe. You know what I mean? Because a lot of y'all sitting over there tasting girlfriends, and she getting more dick than the motherfucking so-called hoe. You know what I mean? Only difference is that hoe sitting up there coming back with a bankroll. Your girlfriend, she just sitting over there giving the pussy to the community while you sitting up there chasing currency at some J-O-B. But it is what it motherfucking is. Me personally, like I said, I don't know how y'all do it. But if you want to sit up there, you know what I mean, and taste the world, you know what I mean, if you want to go from track to track, you know what I mean, state to state, you know what I'm saying, and motherfucking sit up there and put a bitch pussy on your eating plate, you know what I mean, that's on you, man. You know what I'm saying? I can't do it, man. You know what I'm saying, man? My dimples is... You know what I mean? My dimples too big, man. You know what I'm saying? That's for y'all. You know what I mean? That's for y'all niggas. But at the same time, you know what I mean? He was into that. So I asked him before I preached to him, before I reached to him. I stood up there and I said, did you actually think there's some good ass dick and good ass tongue is going to basically, you know, stop this outlandish, faggish behavior that the bitch, you thought that would sit up there and change the mentality of this bitch because you sitting over there, you know what I mean, eating and tasting and licking and lapping and all of this shit? He said, on some real shit, I did. And you know, we be so judgmental, older peas or seasoned peas, niggas be so ready to preach, but I had to go back in my mind before I had did that. See, that's why the young people feel comfortable talking to me, because I just gotta be real. When I first started in the game, Sinful The P started off retarded. Sinful The P started off retarded as a motherfucker. Like I told y'all, some of y'all been watching my videos, so y'all already know. But one of my first bitches, I had took out of the OPM in Vegas. And the way that I had got her, you know, I was retarded, man. You know what I mean? We was dancing at the time. You know, E-40 was on. You know what I mean? She was sitting over there She was sitting over there dancing. You know what I mean? E-40 was hot at the time with T-Pain. You know what I mean? They had that trying to get the you and that monkey. And her ass was just, the ass was just gangbanging. I had to have it, man. You know what I mean? When I seen the bitch, I wasn't sitting over there thinking about, oh, man, I'm about to get, no. I was thinking about fucking. You know, real talk. You know, I wasn't laced right. I came out the incubator of the game retarded because I didn't have the right representation around me to give me the information for me to conform to. So I had to learn by experiences. And all I knew is that I had a sincere desire to pimp, but really didn't have the knowledge, but was sincere, just like many of you. Many of you are sincere. You just sincerely wrong. But you know what I mean? So what ended up happening, right, is basically, you know what I mean, I talked to the bitch, you know what I mean, and man, it didn't take long. We was in the car, fucking. Like young motherfuckers do, 23, you know what I mean? Just caught myself just starting in the game. And you know what I mean? After we fuck some more, you know what I mean? And remind you now, at this time, I'm like a good 5 or 6 days. I'm professing to pee about 5 or 6 days, right? So we talking. She said, what do you do? I said, I just became a pimp. He's 5 or 6. I just became a pimp 5 days ago. You know what I mean? And she was like, no, for real though. She started laughing. I said, no, for real. I did. I just became a pimp. You know what I mean? Just less than a week ago. I just became a pimp less than a week ago. And she was like, no, for real, silly. And once she's caught on to know that I was serious, you know what I mean? She said, you serious, huh? I was like, yeah. So, you know, we laughed and shit. You know what I mean? And I got to keep the story 100. We fucked again. And we ended up chopping it up. You know what I mean? And it went from, you so nice and, you know, I would never see you as no pimp to, you know what I mean? Well, if I was, you know, to be, you know, in the lifestyle, if I was to be with you, how would you treat me? And see, I was smart. Even though I did not have the game at that time, it was just common peace sense for me to say, if I was, wait a minute. So that means that you taking into consideration. You taking it in consideration of basically having some participation in this game. Because if you wasn't thinking about the shit that I'm saying to you, you would have never said, so if I was to be in the game, you know what I'm saying? You wouldn't even think. A woman that abhors the lifestyle, that hates prostitution, that hates the lifestyle of pimping and hoeing, she's not even going to entertain the conversation with you. She not, because she abhors it. She hates it. But if she's listening and she's actually laughing, entertaining, and see, even though I didn't have the game at that time because of the type of young man that I was still nothing to play with because of my upbringing. So once I see that you laughing and you, and then you sitting over there smiling and you like this dick, you know what I mean, and all this, I'm like, man, this is going to be my bitch. Just with that, I knew she was going to be my bitch. You know what I mean? And she did. You know what I mean? Later on that day, you know what I mean? We were sitting over there going to go. You already know in Vegas, you know what I'm saying? And matter of fact, motherfuckers know back in 07, you know, right back, because we were sitting over there chopping up, walking up past the Travel Lodge and shit. You know what I mean? Then we went to the 7-Eleven where Duke and rest in peace YT, you know what I mean, used to be. And we went into, we ended up walking into one of the little sex stores, get a little outfit for the night. And that's how everything started. But I had to learn at that time, the way you start is the way you end. Remember, I came in the door with the dick. I came in with the dick. All right? That's how I came in. So I started, and when I first started with her, you know what I mean? I was fucking her every day. I was fucking that bitch every day. Yeah, I ain't about to sit up here and lie to you. I was fucking that bitch every day. She's a little red bone, cute little ass freeze, remember? I was fucking that bitch every goddamn day, nigga. Every time that bitch came with a bankroll, she, after she take her shower and shit, I listen to her. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And this trick said, woo, woo, woo. Uh-huh, what else happened? You know what I mean? And then woo, woo, woo. And these tricks get on my damn nerves. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Right, right, right. And while she doing that, I'm taking, you know what I mean? I'm taking clothes off. I'm getting ready to get into the mood, man. You know, young and freaky. Now, a lot of motherfuckers gonna tell you hella pimpish stories, and some can honestly tell you that because they was laced properly. But you gotta remember, you know, before I came into the game, I was singing. I was in, you know what I mean, the music and shit. You know what I mean? So I was used to basically sitting up there fucking different girls every night. Because of the lounge group that I was in. So, you know what I mean? When that little demonstration kicked off, she started acting stupid. She started basically going to jail all the time. You know what I mean? And she started turning into somebody different. And I thought at that time, just like I was getting ready to get on him and take the sword out and cut him all in the conversation, I had to reminisce. And the spirit of pimping was like, nigga, you was ignorant at one time too. Have you forgotten how retarded that you used to be? Don't get so high and mighty, nigga, that you forgot how retarded that you used to be in the game. So, as I reminisced about that time, I actually thought that I could keep that bitch, you know what I mean? Because every time that bitch used to do something, you know, at the same time, you know, I'd take her to the barbershop, you know what I mean? Chop her hair a little bit, you know what I'm saying? But most of the time, I would sit up there and fuck, because she was that type of bitch. She was the type of bitch, like I was speaking about earlier, that liked to get into a confrontation, a verbal confrontation, and then have some physical fornication later. That's just how she was. So, you know, the spirit of pimping, man, you know, had to minister to me, and I had to receive the knowledge. I had to go through experiences of bitches blowing up. You know, and then I was doing a lot of dumbass shit, just like some of you young niggas is, you know what I mean? Because I was young, you know what I mean, on fire with the pimping. Freeze all the motherfuckers, remember? You know what I mean? When I first started, I didn't like sleep. I hated sleep, man. You know, man, we was always going 3 to 4 days, you know what I mean, without sleep. Because it felt like in 2007 in Vegas, every time that you went to sleep, man, some sucker-ass nigga came up with that fine, thick-ass, money-getting-ass bitch, or that bitch that you thought that was a money-getting bitch, you know what I'm saying? And some sucker came up with her. You know what I mean? Like, God damn, man, you were asleep. So that's why I hated sleep. But, you know what I mean, moving on, you know what I mean? I had to learn through her and others as well, you know what I mean? The dick can't keep no hoe, man. Dick can't keep no hoe. Can't keep no matter how good your dick is. You know what I mean? And I ain't gonna lie. You know what I mean? You got some bitches that's dick hungry. You know what I mean? You got some bitches that like that good, you know what I mean? As I like to say, man, that good talk, man, for fornication, man. You know what I mean? She like, that's the communication that she like. You got some bitches, you know what I'm saying? And you could already tell, you know, pimps that got good discernment, he could already tell a fuck girl when she get on the phone instantly by the sound of her voice, the way she talking and everything like that. Because a lot of them, you know, they really want to see, you know, what type of nigga that you is. That's why she want to hurry up, get in your inbox, get on the phone, or, you know, if you chopped it up with her at the strip club, met her at the gas station or whatever, she want to hurry up and find out what type of guy you is. You know, man, it's not that she won't be with some, it's not about who, you know, giving the money up. No, she want to know what type of nigga that you is. And it's an up and coming video that I'm going to do, you know, pretty soon. It's going to be called, you know, Proposition 304 No 16. That's the deal that these bitches is trying to get you niggas. Proposition 304 No 16. But that's a later video. But I had to learn through experiences that dick cannot keep a hoe. You know what I mean? It don't matter if you can sit up there, man, and go for 30, 40 minutes. No matter how good your stamina is. You know what I mean? Dick cannot keep no hoe. She getting dick is my brother from another mother. You know what I mean? Gorgeous Dre say, dick can't keep this bitch. You know what I'm saying? And I had to learn that through experience. Because just like many young peas, you trying to fuck your way up to the top. Many are trying to fuck their way to the top. And then once a bitch sit up there, you understand me, and blow up, you know what I mean? And no longer basically want to hoe up for you, she gone. You like, God damn, you know what's wrong? You feeling on your dick like, you know, shit, this shit's still hard as a motherfucker. You know what I mean? You like, what's sinful mean, man, my shit? Hold on, nigga. What you mean, my shit? Nigga, ain't nothing wrong with my dick. How this bitch gonna sit up there, man, and lead this motherfucking pimping, man? Hold on, and this is what a lot of niggas is referring to as they pimping. You know what I mean? Like, how does bitch leave? What's wrong? You know what I mean? Like, hold on. I see some idiot in the comment section, man. Hold on for a minute. Every now and then, I have somebody, you know, on some goofy shit. Hold on. But you actually got niggas that actually think that their dick is the pimpin. You know what I mean? They think that the dick is the pimpin. Hold on. There we go. But yeah, you actually got some niggas that actually think that, you know what I mean, that this, be like, you know what I mean? Like, damn, what happened, man? You know what I mean? It's still the same. It's still the same. You know what I mean? So why did the bitch leave? That's because, nigga, you ran out of game. You might have stood up there, your dick was still on hard, but your pimping was on easy, nigga. You didn't have nothing to offer. When that bitch is talking to that, you know what I mean, that client, man, you know what I mean, that's a giant out here in society, and he got a lot of currency, and the bitch called you, and she said, he said this, you know, I don't know how I should move, you know, what should I do? A bitch gonna get tired of that shit y'all niggas be saying. Bitch call you, one of you niggas, this is just out of conversation, because I've been around motherfuckers, so I already know. Bitch like, you know, and he's talking about, you know, because I know what the price that you told me, and he's saying this, like, you know, how should I negotiate? How should I move about this? Because I'm looking at his watch. He got a perpetual on. He's, you know what I mean? Look like he got some money. And I seen his car in the valet, so I know he got some money. So how should I move about this? And you actually got niggas like, you know what I mean? You just got to be a stump down hoe around this shit. You know what I'm saying? You know the hoeing is in you. You know what I'm saying? You already know. You already know, because you a hoe. You know what I'm saying? Don't be lazy around this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? You got to sit up there and you got to move, man. You got to really be a real bitch. You know what I'm saying? What else? I mean, shit. You know what I mean? You know what price is. You know what I mean? Right. That's, and the bitch just listening to that bitch know you ain't got no instructions, man. You know what I mean? The bitch know basically that you ain't got no instruction. After a bitch be with a nigga for a while, she started learning that he just as ignorant as her. So when she finally come to a conclusion, like, why am I giving the money to a nigga that I got more game than? The only way that you gonna maintain a whole young pimp is this motherfucking pimping. It's some game. That's it. You can't keep no hoe with no dick, man. You know what I mean? It's a lot of niggas, and I ain't knocking that. You know what I mean? Physicality, man, that's good. As the scripture says, you know what I mean? Bodily exercise, it profit a little, but, you know, it profits, though. You know, so I'm not, by all means, go to that gym, keep yourself in shape. But it's a lot of motherfuckers that actually think just because they eating ass and eating pussy and got good dick that they're going to be a giant in this game, and that's not true. That's not so. After you eat up all the motherfucking shit crumbs that's coming out that bitch ass, after you sit up there, you understand me, and lick and lap, and she bounce that pussy on your face, don't get mad at that bitch, man. And that's another thing. One of the main reasons why niggas be ready to sit up there and kill the pimping and shoot the pimping is because after the pimping knocked these niggas for a bitch, you know what I'm saying? Not only was he sticking his dick in the bitch, but he was sticking his feelings in the bitch when he was sticking his dick in. When he was sticking his tongue in there, he was sticking his feelings in there. And all of the nasty shit that he done did in the bedroom, he angry at this bitch for leaving his ass. And now when she chews up with some pimping, he's afraid that all his secrets is about to get told. You know what I'm saying? He ready to kill the pimping. That nigga is ready to sit up there and motherfucking do a David. A lot of y'all niggas don't know the word, but he ready to do what David did to Uriah, you understand me, with this pimping. Because now he's under the impression that the bitch is going to tell all his transgressions that he been doing in the bedroom. You know, and that's why I told you niggas. Now, if you one of them niggas, you comfortable in your sexuality, hey, man, do what you do. But when that bitch sit up there and get into some evangelism, man, with the criticism on your motherfucking name, everybody in the game gonna know all the motherfucking abominable shit you was doing in that motherfucking bedroom. So if you comfortable with walking on the track, walking on the blade and shit, or being somewhere, and you know what I mean, hoes is socializing, you know, niggas is socializing, you know what I mean, about, you know, all the little freaky little things that you did in the motherfucking bedroom, man, you know what I mean, then that's on you, man, you know what I mean, I support you, man, you know, you was a man about yours, but, hey, man, niggas be ready to kill the pimping over these motherfucking secrets that they got. Some of you niggas is allowing bitches to stick her fingers in your booty. You know what I'm saying? Some of you niggas is allowing bitches to stick dildos in your motherfucking ass. Yeah, you doing a whole bunch of motherfucking shit in that bedroom that you ain't got no goddamn business doing. And I don't care. You know, that's your sexual preference. It is what it is. But I just have to keep that shit all the way 100, man. You know what I mean? When you do things like this, just don't be angry at the bitch. And don't try to kill pimping just because this bitch about to tell all your motherfucking secrets, man. You know what I mean? Just because the bitch getting ready to tell all your shit. Oh, yeah. She getting ready to... That hoe getting ready to have a Wendy Williams show with other hoes, man, about all this booty eating that you've been doing. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, my opinion don't have no dominion over what you niggas do in the bedroom. I'm just telling you that every motherfucking action gonna have a reaction. So you might be letting that bitch stick a dildo in your motherfucking ass today, but it's not gonna be funny. See, this is not 1975 and 1979 no more. This is 2000 and motherfucking 17, nigga. So technology is out. You can't get away with the shit that, see, this is what I wanna teach. What was an abomination yesterday is an abomination today. The things that people are doing today, it's not new. It's just that we finding out about it because of technology, man. But there's nothing new under the sun. So since there's nothing new under the sun, they wasn't the first ones to do this motherfucking abominable shit. It's a lot of niggas that we glorified and looked at as legends in the game that have done some abominable things behind closed doors, but they didn't have Facebook Instagram and Worldstar and all of that shit back in the day. But we living in a day now, nigga, when you do something that you ain't got no motherfucking business doing, it's going to be told. And everybody gonna know about it, man. Everybody gonna know about it. So, you know, like I said, just like, you know, I ain't gonna say the nigga name. I ain't gonna get a nigga no free motherfucking, you understand me, show. I ain't gonna get a nigga no free promo. But one thing that I will sit up there and say, this one nigga was trying to go back and forth with me. And he was even telling lies on my name. And I want to tell all you young pimps and older pimps, there's going to be niggas to tell lies on you. You're going to get into some roastings. And you're going to out-mac, verbally attack a nigga. You're going to verbally crucify him. And because he couldn't mentally respond to your shit, he couldn't sit up there and keep up with you, he going to lie on you. And I'm telling you that this game will fight for you. This game will sit up there and abolish anybody that try to establish a name on your motherfucking, you understand me, name in the game. This game gonna fight for you. So, you know what I mean? The same nigga that was lying on me, man, it wasn't even 2 weeks, man, before the truth was revealed on him. A video got put out, you know what I mean, on the nigga on Facebook. This nigga was sucking on the motherfucking dildo right on Facebook. You know what I mean? He's sucking on, he's in the bed with his bitch, sucking on the motherfucking dildo. Now, me personally, I know that we supposed to teach hoes, but it's just certain things that the pimpin' ain't gonna teach these hoes, man. A bitch gonna have to learn on her motherfucking own. I'm not teaching bitches how to suck no dick. I'm not teaching bitches how to throw it back. I ain't teaching bitches how to twerk. I ain't teaching bitches how to suck on no motherfucking dildo or none of that motherfucking shit. You niggas is crazy, man. You know what I mean? And just to keep it all the way 100, man, if you're doing that, you are a homosexual. You know what I mean? But that's what happened. And like I said, man, you know what I mean? This is the type of shit that's going to fuck up your name in this game, man. What you do today is going to come out. Just like it say in the word of God, you can search the scripture. The scripture say your sins shall find you out. Hey, man, your sins gonna find you out in this game. When you basically do something that you ain't got no business doing, such as transgressions, everybody gonna end up finding out about it. Don't think that nobody gonna find out about it. That bitch gonna sit up there and turn into a motherfucking expiration date, and she gonna put it out there, man. So that's why, like I said in my previous video, when I told you niggas in the video of when I first got out of prison, first thing on my mind was to knock a bitch. And I told you niggas, you understand me, play this shit by the rules, man. Play it with class. Play this game with character. Play this game with integrity. Play this game with honesty. You know what I'm saying? That's what you do, bro. Take your tongue out the bitch, bro. I'm not saying like these other weird-ass gay niggas that be telling you, don't fuck your bitch. Nah, man. Pimps gonna fuck they hoes. You know what I mean? A pimp gonna fuck the shit out of a hoe that's sitting over there giving motherfucking loyalty and currency, especially if she been down with you for years and all that shit. You know, who else the fuck he supposed to fuck? A bitch that ain't sitting over there thinking about his pimping, that ain't willing to sit up there, you understand me, and sell some pussy? Motherfuckers sound weird. So pimps gonna fuck his hoe. That's not what I'm saying. But all of this funny style shit the niggas been doing, you know what I mean, in the bedroom and shit like that, cut that shit off, man. It's the spirit of pimping speaking. I already know right now we damn near got 300 motherfuckers that's watching. It's a few of y'all, probably more than that, many of y'all that's doing what I'm saying. You know what I mean? And this ain't nothing but the butt-naked irrefutable truth about this game, man. Stop doing that. It's gonna find you out. Stop doing that. The spirit of pimping is speaking to you right now, man. Warning come before destruction. All right? So now that the spirit of pimping is ministering to you, because a lot of y'all gonna be in the comment section laughing, and you know what I mean? Oh man, PD's niggas, man. And a lot of niggas is gonna be laughing, and they in the same motherfucking shit that I'm talking about. But I'm gonna tell you this, I warned you, you know the consequences of your actions. If you decide to sit up there and still, you know what I mean, do that shit, hey, that's on you. You know what I mean? But I told you, good dick ain't gonna keep no hoe. You got to pimp. You got to pimp, man. You got to have some game. You got to have information, man. And that's another thing. You know what I mean? Because there's a lot of y'all, you know what I'm saying, that you know, only allow your girl to work on Backpage. And like I keep telling you, Backpage ain't gonna put you on the front page of this game. I've been telling y'all that for a while now. But it's for some of y'all, you know what I mean? You got these prostitutes being the motherfucking square ass secretary and all that shit, accepting phone calls, waiting on the money to come to her. You know, and I wanna tell you this, for you motherfuckers that got a bitch in a room all goddamn day, you the motherfuckers that really have to have conversation for a bitch. You know what I'm saying? You got to have motherfucking conversation for a bitch, man. You know what I mean? I just got to be all the way 100. You the motherfuckers that really got to have conversation for a bitch. Why you say that, Sin? Because that bitch is in that room all goddamn day. And she's calling you all goddamn day. You know what I'm saying? And that Backpage shit, it's a killer. You sitting over there receiving phone calls from a bitch, and she expects you to be on the motherfucking phone as long as you was on the phone yesterday. She made $1,700 yesterday. So she wants you to sit up there and be on the phone and answer the phone for her the same way that she had made the $1,700. But today, she only made $180, pimp. Or she only made $230. And she wants you to talk to her for 230 years within a 24-hour period because she having a sad, bad day and nobody is calling her funky ass. You know what I'm saying? You motherfuckers that only got bitches working Backpage, man, you niggas got it bad, man. First of all, it's no consistency with the currency. Some niggas, they got a whole little Backpage plan, and that's what's up, you know. But I'm warning you, I'm even warning you with that, man. Warning come before destruction. You niggas have to pimp, man, because sooner or later, Backpage is going to close. The girlfriend, the little man meet woman, woman man section on Backpage, that's going to close too. What you going to do, man? What you going to do? What you going to do? What are you going to do, man? When that shit sit up there, you understand me, and fail, when that bitch call and say, Daddy, or whatever your name is, you know, I only send bitches on Backpage to pee. I don't let bitches go outside to pee. When she finally call you and you don't have no pimping, what are you going to do? What you gonna do? You know what I'm saying? All the niggas that you was laughing at for sending bitches on the track, they gonna be laughing at you because they know you don't got no game for the track. They know you don't got no game to send a bitch in the casino, restaurant, bar, or to another motherfucking country, nigga, to go get some bread. They know you don't have that. You know what I'm saying? What are you going to do? You better be listening, man. You know what I mean? Like I say, warning come before destruction. And I'm telling you, niggas, that's gonna come to a close. You know what I'm saying? The money that you getting right now, you better be saving your money. That's why I always said, if you save your money will save your ass. Some of you niggas is allowing these bitches to be on Backpage, and you spending money like this run is always going to last. Let me tell you, Young P, something. That bitch could have sat up there and just got through swallowing your nut. She stole two watches. She sucked you all up. She made you feel like a man. She made you feel like the biggest P. Let me sit up there and tell this to you niggas, man. Every run has an expiration date on it. Every run has an expiration date on it. Some get longer runs than others because some niggas have more pimping than others. Some niggas get a longer run than others because some niggas signed a deal that pimping couldn't sign. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? For you niggas that's getting a run or whatever, you know, it is what it is. But I said all that to say this. All runs have an expiration date. What you gonna do when that run expires? What you gonna do when that bitch tell you that she no longer wanna do this no more? Because once them bitches get to 30 or a little bit past 30, the spirit of faggotry, the spirit of a fag come over the bitch, and she starts saying shit like, you know, have you ever thought about what you gonna do, you know, after the game? Do you ever think about getting married? She gonna start asking all of these faggot ass questions. You know what I mean? That's because the spirit of faggotism is ministering to this bitch. And if you don't have the medication for the situation, which is some motherfucking pimping, that spirit of faggotry is going to evolve. The bitch is going to become more demonic. She's going to become more faggot. Your money is going to become shorter. She's going to start bird feeding you. At first, the bitch was sitting over there reaching for your pimping. The bitch was sitting up there bringing Rolexes and some more shit. You know what I'm saying? And now Bitch ain't hit a watch, ain't hit a watch or nothing, no ring, no, ain't hit a lick since motherfucking, you understand me, as I like to say, King Harriet was riding in chariots around this motherfucker, man. Now the bitch coming in here with 450s and 600, 700, the way that she, you know, would pay some gym shoe ass nigga. You know what I'm saying? So what you gonna do, man? You know what I mean? This is giving preparation. You got to go on a mental safari within your mind, man, and get your pimping together. Warning come before destruction, young pimp. What are you going to do? You know what I mean? I done already told you, nigga. Back page is going in. I done told you, niggas, you understand me? You better save your money. Some of y'all, and I'm going to say this too, while the spirit of wisdom is upon me. Nigga, y'all better sit up there and keep a bondsman paid. You know what I mean? Warning come before destruction, young pimp. Keep a bondsman paid. Keep a lawyer paid, man. And that, and it's not just for pimps, for even you squares. Anything could happen, man. Get you a lawyer. Keep a bondsman paid, man. Keep that lawyer paid. You never know what situation awaits you on today. You know what I'm saying? And like I keep saying in every other video, sit down with your family, pimp. Sit down with your hoe. Sit down with your hoes, man, and get your own language. Get your own language, man. You know what I mean? In the game, you know, you got to get your own language. You know what I mean? To speak to your family, to speak to your hoes, man. You know, because like I said, when you locked up and fucked up, you know what I mean? And hold on. When you locked up, you know what I'm saying? And fucked up. You know what I mean? And things like that. And you on that motherfucking phone. I don't want you to be like the rest of these niggas. Suge in the situation right now. I know other P's in the situation. I knew a nigga by the name of V-Mac out the Bay for tampering with a witness, man. You niggas got to learn how to talk on that phone. The moment that you get on the phone, it say these calls are being monitored. And niggas still get on there. Yeah, man. You know what I mean, man? It's pimping, man. You know what I'm saying? You already know what it is with me, man. You know what I mean? It's pimping, man. You know, and them people is listening to you. And if you would have took heed to what the spirit of pimping was saying when I was sitting up there speaking to you, all you had to do was sit down with your family, man. Sit down with your women, you know what I'm saying, to talk to them. You know what I mean? To sit down with all of your women, man, and get your own language. Because when you on the phone with them broads, man, and you want to say something, but you can't say it because the cause is being monitored. But remember what the spirit of pimping gonna remind you. You remember when you was watching that YouTube video? You remember when sin was preaching to you? You remember when sin was ministering? You was like, that's some good game, and you didn't take heed? This is the results. So you either going to sit up there and comply to this game, or you're going to allow this game, man, to fall to the motherfucking wayside, man. You know what I mean? Don't allow this game to fall to the wayside. Please, by all means, young peas, take heed to this game, man. Take heed to this game. So we're going to keep a lawyer paid. We're going to keep a bondsman paid. We're going to sit up there, you understand me, and make preparation because of what I tell you. I wasn't prophesying. This is just the reality. Backpage, that's going to shut down. That's going to go down. But see, when you got game, even when Backpage sit up there and go down, your money is still going up. Why? Because the game that's within you, you got to get that mentality that whatever problems of life, whatever problems of this lifestyle, the game that is within me is the solution to any problem. This bitch, that bitch, or any bitch can't bring a motherfucking problem that's greater than the solution that is within me. And that's this game, man. That's this pimping. Each and every day you gotta be thinking when them broads are sleeping, you know what I mean? Are they on the phone or you allowing them to do shit that I wouldn't do? Are you allowing them to watch Love and Hip Hop and all of that shit? You gotta be thinking, pimp. You gotta be thinking, man. Getting your game together. You know what I mean? That's why the pimping ain't got no business sitting over there socializing and shit. You know what I'm saying? With niggas that ain't got no uncommon information and inspiration to give, man, about this damn pimping. You got to stop communicating with people that ain't about this pimping, man. You young pimps, listen, I'm going to teach you how to zone out. When you really want to become serious about this game, you only hang around people that's serious about the game, period. You don't need to be around people that got these old friendly, you know, conversations as far as like digging a bitch down and no. You need to be around pure pimps. Get around them veterans, man. Get around them older pimps. Stop hanging around niggas that's telling you that the way they got this car and ring and chain, you know what I'm saying, was through eating ass and all of this shit. You know, that's that sucker shit. Stay with this pimping, man. Play this shit by the rules. Like I told you in that last video, if I didn't play by the rules, Sinful would have had herpes. Those of you that watched that video, y'all already know the story. If I did not play the game by the rules, I would have herpes right now. I'd be in that same condition that they think that Usher or profess that Usher has right now. If I did not play the game by the motherfucking rules. That's why you have to play this game by the rules. Some of you are going on these interviews and you know that these broads is ignorant of what the real game is. You know that these bitches, you understand me? You know what I mean? It's ignorant of the game and you taking advantage of the bitch's ignorance. Oh, bro, if you want to know the story, you're going to have to go back to the video. That's not what I'm on. But you know what I mean? By you knowing that the broad is ignorant, you taking advantage of that. You know what I mean? So a lot of you is sitting over there because the bitch is pretty or she's thick and you taking your dick out and you fucking on the bitch. You know what I mean? Your sex shouldn't be... That ain't even on your mind, young pimp. Your mind is conditioned to pimp. That's the only thing on your mind is to read, get your body right, get your mind right. And for right now, until you basically, you know what I mean? It's just like a young minister. It's just like anybody in the Fruit of Islam or how they do with the young people in holiness. They don't allow people to get involved in spirituality. They only listen to music that exalts God, you know what I'm saying, and spirituality. They don't listen to anything of carnality. They don't listen to any of that shit. So that's the same way that I want you to be about this game for right now. For those of you that just started, you only need to be listening to music that supports pimpish thoughts. You only need to be hanging around people with profound it don't necessarily even got to be about pimping, but it got to be something intellectual that you can gain from. Okay? So in the Fruit of Islam, you know, if you were one of the Fruit of Islam or you're a young bro, I'm talking about people who are strict. Or are you a Seventh-day Adventist or one of the brothers, the Black Hebrew Israelites? They study. They study to the maximum. Why? Because they want to represent Islam. Because they want to represent being a Black Hebrew Israelite. Because they want to represent Pentecostalism or they want to represent holiness. That's why they do that. So in order for you to be that pimp that you desire to be, that successful pimp, that when you talk, people can hear the anointing and the power of the game, you're going to have to abstain and refrain from doing things that you see other niggas doing. You're going to have to separate yourself from others. You're going to have to separate yourself in your conversation. You might even have to separate yourself even in your attire. You want to be different. You want them broads. When you come, you walk into anywhere, they should know that that's such and such, such and such. Because he wear this. That's such and such, such and such. Because he speak like this. He only do this and this and this. You want your reputation to be so motherfucking clean in this game that when somebody lie on you, instantly motherfuckers is ready to kill them for lying. That's how you want it to be in this game, young P and young peas. Another thing that I don't want you to do, I'm not God or anything like that, but I want you to stay off these motherfucking drugs, man. I want you to stay off these drugs. You got to stay off these motherfucking drugs, man. You know what I mean? A lot of times, let me say this. A lot of times, you know, a pimp really don't be having nobody that he can relate to. Especially if he's young in the game, you know, he trying to find a friend or he trying to find somebody that he can fuck with. And he's afraid to admit his frailties. his iniquities. He's afraid to sit up there and talk about, you know what I mean, what's going on with him and his household, because he feels like if he exposes that, then basically the person that he exposed it to will sit up there and knock him for all of his bribes. So a lot of times, niggas, you know what I mean, when they run into a problem or a situation, they dependent on drugs. You know what I mean? Leave them drugs alone, man. Leave them drugs alone. Stay clean and off them drugs. You want to separate yourself. The probability of you being successful in any criminal lifestyle or just successful in life, period, positive and negative, is higher when you are not on drugs. Leave those drugs alone. There's some people right now that's walking the yard. They're in a correctional facility right now. And they got years to do, some got life to do. And they would not be there right now if they wasn't on drugs when they committed that crime. Or some didn't even commit the crime, but due to the fact that they were on drugs or something like that, they ended up in a wrong situation that led them to incarceration. Everybody that's locked up right now is not guilty. Some of y'all have a regular square mentality. If they're there, they should be there. Nah, you know what I mean? But I'm telling you, young peas, stay off the drugs, man. You know what I'm saying? And another motherfucking thing that I want to sit up there and say, just keeping that thing all the way real, you know, don't try to be like a rapper. You know what I mean? I just got to keep that thing all the way real, because, you know, all of the rappers and, you know, so-called celebrities, they wanted to be like the pimping. We got to bring that back. The P's got to bring that back. You don't want to be like Future. You don't want to, no. Percocet, no. Fuck all of that. Keep your mind clean. Stay off them motherfucking drugs, man. You know what I mean? I'm saying this out of love. You know, I don't know who I'm speaking to right now. You know what I mean? Whoever the spirit of pimping got me ministering to right now. Leave them motherfucking drugs alone, P. You a pimp so much better. It's so many pimps. I'm not going to call them by their names that I've known that would have been so much greater, that never reached their full potential in the game simply because they were on drugs, man. Some niggas kept going in and out of jails, in and out of prison because they was on drugs, man. Leave them motherfucking drugs alone, man. I'm speaking out of love for your freedom. I'm speaking out of love for your mother. I don't want your mother going back and forth to visitation and looking at you through some motherfucking TV screen with a phone, looking at her baby and shit. You could avoid the misunderstandings by getting an outstanding understanding tonight by leaving the motherfucking drugs alone. But moving right along, man, another motherfucking thing, you know what I mean? It's just so much with this pimping, man. You could just never run. You can never run out of subjects. You can never run out of things to talk about. But to get the pimping where it need to be, you know what I mean, or how it should appear, hey, man, some of y'all be on Facebook. Some of y'all be on these social media, you know what I mean, groups and things like that, and you making these bitches more important than what they really are. Seeing how am I doing that? You constantly in her inbox, you know what I mean, giving all of these booty-licking-ass compliments all the motherfucking time. If she's an attractive bitch, P, she already be hearing that all the time. Stop liking these bitches' pictures, man. She already got 300-400 or 1,000 motherfuckers to do that. Stop liking her picture. She don't need that like for you. What she do need from you is for you to say something that nobody else is saying to her. That's what she need. She need an individual to mentally stimulate her. That's what she need, P. You know what I mean? Tap into your pimping, man. Get into the spirit of pimping and allow the spirit of pimping to minister to your mind on how you should basically convey your game to this woman. What's going to separate me from the next P? Even when you driving up and down the track, when you going up and down the track, listen to them motherfuckers hollering out the window. Listen to what, before you sit up there and bless a bitch with your game, listen to what they holler. See what they sitting up there saying. You don't want to say the same thing that everybody else is saying to the bitch. Because when you say the same thing that everybody else is saying to the damn bitch, you in that same motherfucking category. So when you driving up and down the track and you spitting your game, man, you know what I'm saying? And you giving it to it, because see, when the spirit of pimping is on you, you ain't got to rehearse, you ain't got to freestyle. It just flow. the spirit of pimping will rest upon you. And when you open your mouth, it'll just flow like that. And the bitch trying to do her best to stay in pocket. You know what I'm saying? But the pimping keep beating the shit out of her motherfucking ear. She can't run from it. And you only gonna be like that. You gotta read, you gotta study, you gotta think, and you gotta separate your conversation from the mother. Most niggas on the track, they don't have nothing to say to a bitch. They only saying the same thing that they heard from Pimps Up, Hoes Down, or a UGK song, or Sugar Free. Most of them niggas don't have, listen man, originality, man, is a necessity, you know what I'm saying, to be a pimp, man. You gotta have some originality, you know what I mean, about what you're saying. Period. You know what I mean? Like, a lot of you, I don't say nothing when I see a lot of y'all posting my shit on Facebook, on your Twitter and shit like that, and you be posting it like it came from your mind. But I want to tell you that that's disrespectful to your mind by taking something that came from my mind and presenting it to a bitch or whoever like it's yours. I ain't talking about the information, by all means. You know, because even after a lot of y'all hear this game, a lot of y'all gonna try to apply it, but it ain't gonna work. Why? Because you ain't this pimping. You know what I mean? That's why I tell motherfuckers, don't get angry because a motherfucker heard this game. They just knowledgeable about shit they can never do. You know, Michael Jordan write a book about dunking from free throw line. A fat motherfucker, a motherfucker that ain't got the right physicality, he not gonna sit up there and be able to dunk from the motherfucking free throw line. And he can read that book as many times as he want to. But I said all that to motherfuckers, say this, man. Separate yourself. Get your motherfucking conversation together, man. You know, most niggas, like I said, they don't have nothing to say. Yeah, baby. You know what I'm saying? You really got action, you know? 702-432-9642. Yeah, pull over the P. Yeah, out that Dago. You know what I mean? Then you got another nigga. Yeah, you know? Let your next move be your best move, baby. You know what I mean? You really got action and getting satisfaction from a king tonight. You know, I just had to let you know. Then you got another nigga. You know, don't look down, but look up and look what you're looking. You know what I mean? Don't motherfucking miss this. You know what I mean? Like, that's nothing. You know what I mean? Like, they saying the same shit. You know what I mean? Some niggas don't even have no words. They just 414-323-421-ho, bitch. You know what I'm saying? You know, when you get that trap, you know what I'm saying? Give it to a real nigga, though. You know what I'm saying? Rush it to a real one, though, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's FedEx the P, bitch. It's FedEx the P. Then you got another nigga in the back seat yelling out the window. Yeah, bitch, you know what I'm saying? It's Allie Mac for two D's for a double dose of this pimpin'. Even though it ain't no D's in Allie Mac, I just want you to know, bitch, you got action at a real one, though, bitch. You really got action at a real one, though. You know what I'm saying? And this is the shit that these niggas is saying. You know what I mean? This is the shit that these niggas are saying. They think that a bitch gonna get out of pocket for saying, I mean, she might laugh when she get out your presence. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, bitch, you know what I'm saying? It's Comcast the P, bitch. Comcast trying to get it out your ass, though, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Really trying to get a connection, you know what I mean, around here, bitch. I'm hearing that your whole cable is fucked up. You know what I mean, bitch? Well, call me the cable man, bitch, because I'm trying to get inside your mind and spend time to put the motherfucking connection together, though, bitch. Yeah, that nigga that you with, bitch, he don't know what he doing around here, bitch. Your cable been on for a minute, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Your cable is the definition of basic. Just face it. You know what I'm saying? The nigga that you're fucking with, he ain't it, bitch. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? They saying the same shit. They not sitting over there, you know what I mean? They not saying anything original, man. A lot of the shit that they saying is just, it's the plain Jane ass shit. It ain't no real shit. You know what I mean? I really want you to know, bitch. You know what I'm saying? And then you got niggas that really be trying. They be looking around before they say the shit. You know what I mean? But trying to get sexual with the bitch. You know what I mean? Got some sexy music. Oh, sexy can I ass nigga. He pulling up on the bitch. Yeah, you know. I know your nigga ain't fucking you right. You know what I'm saying? He ain't dicking you down the way that you should be dicked down around this motherfucker, though. You know what I'm saying? Bitch, Bitch, I'ma let you know, bitch, I'm not no motherfucking pimp, bitch. I'm a Mac, though, you know what I'm saying? Real talk, bitch, you can put your motherfucking trap with my trap, and we put it together, though, you know what I'm saying? Like a real one, man, just being 100, though, bitch. You know what I'm saying? I'm not no motherfucking pimp, bitch. You know what I mean? A pimp, all he say is gimme, 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 gimme. You know, I'm not no gimme-ass nigga, though. You know what I'm saying? I'm a nigga that's gonna sit up there and put my buffet with your salad bar so we can eat. You know what I'm saying? Real macking at you, though, bitch. Fuck with a gangster, though, bitch. Fuck with a nigga that's gonna really protect you around here. You know what I mean? Nigga gonna know. You know what I mean? You know? I'm just gonna keep it all the way, like, 100, you know what I mean? Like, that's, come on, man. You know, for you peas, I want you to, I see you, Tommy, what's up? We could talk later. But, you know what I mean? Tommy, yeah, Tommy Sotomayor. But, you know what I mean? We got to sit up there, you understand me, and be original, man. We got to have originality with what we saying. When a bride hear you speak, it got to be brand new, baby. You know what I'm saying? She shouldn't hear you and say, you know what? That nigga be watching Sinful. You know what I mean? He shouldn't be, nah. You know what I mean? It shouldn't be like that. You know what I mean? Just real talk. It should never be like on some motherfucking, yeah. You know what I mean? He been watching Pimpin' Ken. It should never be like, oh, he got that from Gorgeous Dre. Or, you know what I mean, he got that from Freeze. Or he got that from Sinful. It should only be you, man. You know what I mean? I just got to keep that shit all the way like 100 with you. It's got to be some type of originality, man. You know what I mean? Another thing that a lot of you niggas is doing. And you be like, damn, man, it feel like Sinful in my house. I know. But a lot of you niggas be watching so-called pimp videos, you know what I mean? You be sitting over there watching pimp videos with your bride. Now, let me break this down. Certain people you can watch, you know what I mean? Because I'm going to keep it all the way 100. Gorgeous Dre is not trying to knock you for your bride because, well, Dre is married, you know what I mean? And me, you know what I mean? When y'all come to me as little brothers, I'm not in debt. That's one thing about Sinful The P. If I brought you into this, or if I've birthed you, if I've helped you get involved and evolve into this lifestyle, I'm not going to try to snake you for a bitch. Because I realize, you know what I'm saying, that what we could possibly build as far as unity in the game is just more important than any bitch. All right? So just keeping that thing all the way 100, when you make a woman that important, you know, you make a woman more important in this game. Stop trying to pimp, out-pimp basically your pimp partner by getting at his bitch when he sleep or something like that. Like, for example, y'all know that Freeze is my partner. I would never, ever, you know what I'm saying, get at my partner bitch. You got to decide whether or not you fucking with pimping or you going to sit up there and try to have the bitch, man. Which one you gonna do? And a lot of niggas try, they think that this pimp game is whoever can tell the best lie. They think that the pimp game is some conniving con artist individual because of these male actresses that have been on these documentaries, you know what I mean, giving basically these lies. Because that is a lie. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, like a motherfucker say, the friendship end when the pimping begin. I don't believe that. You know what I'm saying? If you my nigga, you know, because in this game, let me tell you, young pimp, something. In this game, you gonna need something. You gonna need more than the bitch. You gonna need more than the hoe. You know what I'm saying? Because bitches turn into expiration dates all the time. And the pimping is a blessing to pimping. So it's the pimping that's gonna be putting money on your books. It's the pimping that's gonna be making them three-way calls. It's the pimping that, you know what I mean, it's a lot of motherfucking gangbangers and strangers that got a lot of hatred for the pimping. Who you think gonna be helping you fight? Who you think that's gonna be sitting over there going to war with you when it's motherfuckers that's built like Shaq trying to motherfucking physically attack your ass? The motherfucking ism, nigga. So how dare you sit up there and put a bitch, you know what I mean, above this game? We glorify the game above the bitch. The bitch is not equivalent to this game. Not at all. Not at all. And so that's why, and for you people that's outside of the lifestyle, you're not a pimp. You don't have no desire to be a pimp. I respect you and I loved you because you come to that conclusion. I wish it was a bigger population of you guys. But I want to say this to you too, because I'm going to do another video talking about this, the black woman is God type of shit. See, we got so many people that's pumping a lot of bullshit in the YouTube community and in the streets, and it's messing up the minds of our young people. It's messing up the minds of our young men. It's messing up the minds of these up and coming, you know what I mean, young men. I'm speaking about people that's even outside of the pimp game. And you had so many people, you know, just like in my last video that got in the comment section, oh man, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, Tommy's here. I'm going to say it even while he's here. Oh, man, you sticking up for Tommy. Man, Tommy should have. No, but what about, you know, he was disrespecting the black queens and stuff like that. And I say this is why Tommy is here. I don't agree with everything that Tommy Sotomayor, you know what I mean, says. But at the same motherfucking time, you know what I mean, all of this, Harry Met Sally, Love Jones, Sleepless in Seattle, booty kissing and shit that you niggas be doing, you know what I mean? Hell no. You know what I mean? All of this, you know, as I like to say, all you catch your grenade for the P-ass niggas, you ready to catch your grenade for the bitch? You ready to die over the bitch? As I like to say, no, baby, don't step into the mud. Here's my coat, you know, for the bitch. And fight your mama over the bitch. Slap God and punk Jesus for the bitch. We don't do that over here in this channel, man. So that's why when I see that shit going on in my comment section, I have to take time out to rebuke you motherfucking niggas, because you ain't got no damn business in my comment section with that. You got so many other platforms to get your Carl Thomas on and be emotional all in the comment section. Don't do that in my shit, though. You know what I mean? No, we not doing that over here. We got young people that be watching my videos. You got young people that's in high school to tell me that they actually be missing sleep to watch my videos when I be up late at night. So when you see guys all up in the motherfucking comment section and they just motherfucking just ready to kill me, ready to kill a P, you know what I'm saying, or ready to even kill Tommy because of things, his opinion. See, and I say this even while he's here, or just anybody. See, the reason why I would have never hit Tommy and if I was even in their position, because when they did that, just like I said in the last video, when they physically did that, they allowed him to know that he was important. I would have never did that. When anytime somebody says something verbally and you think that that was just so like powerful that you want to put physical force on the individual, you lost. Because I taught you guys to what? Mentally respond and not emotionally react. See, in the pimp game, when it get on that level, and I'm going to say this too, I'm glad I touched it. That's just the spirit of pimping. When you around some pimps and they having an argument with each other and they going back and forth, you know, you allow them to have a cookout. You allow them niggas to go back and forth. But when it becomes too disrespectful, stop the shit. Don't allow them niggas to fight or anything. We actually have lost pimps in the game to prison in the motherfucking graveyard because pimps did not step in when they were supposed to. If you go back and go to Google and put in, I forgot his government name, but a P partner of mine out of Texas, he got into it with another P that was from Northern Cali, and they was at the Palms. Some of y'all already know what I'm speaking about. They was at the Palms, and they got into it. This could have been avoided if niggas would have just stepped in and say, hey man, this conversation ain't pimpish. Y'all need to let this shit go. Right now, this conversation ain't pimpish, man. Y'all, go on to your car, P. Move the fuck on, man. Y'all doing too much. You know what I'm saying? But by nobody doing that, we got one pimp that died that night, that was killed that night, and we got another pimp that ended up losing, I think, 15 to 16 years of his motherfucking life. He's on parole right now. That could have been avoided if niggas wasn't laughing and hee-heeing and ha-ha. I'm talking about love for this game. And I'm still with the message. See, when you really got love for the game, that means that you following the rules, number one, but that means that your love for this pimping is bigger You understand me? Than your love for sexual pleasure. So when you really govern and consume by the spirit of pimping, pussy is not your number one priority. When you speak to a broad, when you're having a mental safari with a square, you investigating this broad. You trying to find out if the broad is even worthy enough to even hoe for you. Because every pretty ass bitch with a motherfucking ass that's big enough to fuck up the toilet ain't even worthy of hoeing for you. Every bitch is not worthy to pay a pimp. And I know some of y'all is looking like, damn, that was an arrogant ass statement. You mean to tell me that the bitch ain't worth? Right. And I'm going to say it again. Every bitch is not worthy to even pay a pimp. Bitch, you not even worthy to even sit up there and do a date for a pimp. Some of you niggas be sitting over there looking at these pretty faces, and I'm telling you that these new faces is going to cause you to have some new cases. You better sit up there and have some discernment, because if you don't sit up there and properly interview the broad, which, you know, bro told me to do a video, I'm going to do a video about interviewing the broad. If you don't, you're going to find yourself, as I like to say, you're going to find yourself in the correctional facility with no motherfucking currency singing Deborah Cox, nigga, how did I get here? That's what the fuck is going to happen. Because you didn't take heed to Sinful the P when the spirit of pimping was talking to your motherfucking ass. That's just 100. When you talking to a broad, listen to the conversation. And that's why I read even the word of God. A lot of y'all be thinking I'm crazy. But when you go to the book of Isaiah and you read the 14th chapter, Lucifer, every word, every time he initiates a conversation, all he keeps saying is, I. So, you know what I mean? Every time it say, I, that's letting you know that this individual is selfish. And most conversations with women of today, especially in their 20s, all they speaking about is I. That's it. And if a bitch is constantly saying, I want this. I want this. And this is what I wanted. And he didn't do this because I, right off top, P, she letting you know that she not worthy to hoe for you. She not worthy to sit up there and fuck with this pimping, bro. Because seeing this pimping and hoeing, the reason why the game is not as fruitful and prosperous as it used to be is because everybody is selfish. That's why. Because when he's on the phone or when he's talking to the bride, he's not even investigating to find out if this bitch is even worthy to hoe for him. He's only thinking about money. And when you're only thinking about money, you're going to be selfish. The woman, the most of these brides, when they talk to the pimpin', they trying to only find out what they're going to get. So everybody's selfish. Everybody has become selfish. It's become only about money. It's been about money. But whenever money becomes above principle, we have a problem. We got a big problem. We got a big ass problem. And that's what's happening. A lot of niggas is sitting over there socializing with a broad. He see her physical appearance, and her appearance is the definition of marketability. And he think that the probability of him making a lot of currency with this broad is very motherfucking high. So, you know what I mean? Instead of, you know, listening to this bitch's hoography and finding out what the bitch did in ancient times, you know what I'm saying? He just trying to send her in these recent times so he can sit up there, you understand me, and get his motherfucking money. And then when, you know what I mean, the police is at his door knocking, or when the feds come, you know what I mean? Or when he catch a human trafficking, he's sitting up in jail like with his hand over his face saying, where did I go wrong? Where did I go wrong? You know what I mean? Where did I go wrong? How did I get here? And I'm telling you how you got wrong. Selfishness, you know what I mean, will lead you to being incarcerated. Being desperate. A lot of you niggas are desperate right now. You only got a piece of a bitch. You got a bitch that's making $300 to $400 by the grace of God. And you paying for a hotel room that's $100. You paying for weed every day. You paying for food. And it seems like that you can't prosper. And you keep, you know what I mean? The bitch keep leaving you. And just like my young pea partner that I spoke about earlier, you keep accepting the bitch back. Why you keep accepting the bitch back? Because you're desperate to pee. A lot of you niggas cannot pimp properly. You can't pimp correctly. You can't pimp accordingly because you get into a continuity of basically sitting over there accepting any bitch that want to choose with you. The pimping is not like that. Everybody can't get into Harvard University. Everybody can't get into Stanford University. And every woman cannot choose the pimping. Every woman can't choose the pimping. Every woman shouldn't be able to sit up there, you understand me, and choose this pimping. You know what I mean? So, you know, just keeping that thing all the way like 100, if you accept any bride that tries to basically choose with you, a bitch gonna sit up there and be like, a real bitch, an attractive bitch that's really getting money, she gonna look at this nigga and be, this nigga accept anybody. That's why when you look at a nigga and he got a stable full of fat ass, handsome bitches and shit, these Rush Limbaugh looking ass bitches, you know, it shows that he really doesn't care about the game really like that. He's not really trying to glorify the game. You know what I'm saying? I'm just being 100. Now, some peas is different. Some peas can get a ransom out of a bitch that's handsome. But at the same particular time, you know, that ain't what a pimp looking for. A pimp's mentality is, I am the best, so that's what the fuck I deserve. I don't want what's, you know what I mean, anybody that just, you know, want to fuck with me. No, that ain't how this game go. You know what I mean? So with that being said, just keeping that thing all the way like 100, you know what I mean, just putting things in perspective because I'm about to wrap things up. The pimping don't accept any bitch, you know what I mean, to get in his inbox, you know what I mean? And you watch it too. Let me say this too. Man, it's so much to talk about. But these bitches that's getting in your inbox and your DM and they sitting over there talking about some, what's your choosing fee? You better watch that shit. Because behind a lot of them profiles, that be them people. That's the motherfucking feds. That's the people, man. You know what I'm saying? Be careful what you say. Speak indirectly, but directly when you on there. You know what I'm saying? Don't say, just like for right now, a nigga can make a video talking about he the greatest pimp alive. And he could never really get locked up because they could just think that he's some egotistical nigga that's just fantasizing about being a pimp. But when you got videos of you basically breaking hoes, accepting money that appears that basically got from the acts of prostitution, when you riding in the car with the broads and you want to show the faces because you felt that they was just so pretty, you know, it was so gorgeous tonight that you had to show these bitches, you know what I mean? This is a predestined case that's waiting to happen. Allow the spirit of pimping to minister to you, man. Always mentally respond. You know what I mean? Yo, I told you niggas, your desire for glorification is going to cause you to be in incarceration. That's what's going to happen. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, going back to the original message, man. You know what I mean? Your dick ain't longer than this pimping, man. When your dick goes soft, the pimping's still going hard, man. You know what I mean? Don't be mad at the pimping, man. You know what I mean? When you done fucked that bitch, when you done stuck a motherfucking 10, 15 inch dick up in that bitch, and you mad as fuck because the bitch done blew up, and she done chose up with a nigga that looked like 8-Ball with no motherfucking MJG, decided to give her motherfucking money from her pussy to him tonight, and you got some old ugly fat pimp calling you like, yeah, man, I'm just calling you, man, letting you know, man, you know, the bitch, man, decided to reach me tonight, man. You know, you ain't got to worry about the bitch. You know what I mean? She ain't dead. She ain't been killed. I know, Pete, when you sat up there and called the jail and gave the government name, you felt like, damn, you know what I mean? This bitch ain't called me. She ain't in jail. I hope this bitch ain't dead. Nah, man, she not dead, man. She about my bread right now. But yeah, Pete, I wanted to know, man, you know what I mean? Can I get them things? Can I get them clothes, man? And a real pimp, you know what I mean? He gonna sit up there, you understand me? And give it with no motherfucking hesitation. You know what I mean? Now, not to glorify myself above everybody else, but what other nigga do you know that did a video with a nigga that knocked him for the first very time? You know what I'm saying? I did a motherfucking video with a nigga that gave me my first phone call and we still cool today. If that nigga was to sit up there right now and go holus and dolus, he can jump on the phone and call Sinful The P for a jug and stay at my motherfucking place at any time. Why? Because it's pimping. That's why. Who done did that? What other P do you know in the game that did a video with the nigga that knocked him for a bitch happy and smiling? Not too long ago, the nigga just got an S550 out that bitch. And I ain't gonna lie, you know what I mean? That was a good bitch too. You know what I mean? Paid the shit out of me. You know what I mean? Had some good mannerism. You know what I mean? She was good, man. Beyond the, you know, the money part and all that, she was attractive. She was good looking. Pussy was good, too. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah. You know what I mean? I had fun. You know, I got my funds and fun out the bitch. Got my run out of the bitch. Had that bitch on automatic, man, for damn near over 4 months. You know what I mean? Having reunions with Western Union. You know what I mean? Checking it like the house was on fire. Getting my desire every motherfucking night. And one night, man, I got that phone call. And when I got the phone call, I don't know, man. You know, I guess it's just in me because, you know them stories that niggas be telling when they was like their heart got hit and they was ready to kill and all of that? I ain't feel like that. I accepted. We talked. We chopped it up. Instantly, I felt the spirit of pimping on him. I knew what it was with him. I knew that he wasn't lying. You know what I mean? About him being a pimp. You know what I'm saying? And we basically knew some of the same P partners in the game after chopping it up. And we've been talking, man, ever since. We've been cool ever since. I love him like a brother. What else, nigga, do you know to do a damn video with the nigga that took food from his table? Took, you understand me, a bitch, you know what I mean, from out of stable. What other nigga you know did a video like that? Now, other niggas might sit up there, you know what I mean, and show this, but, I mean, who put paint, you know what I mean, where it ain't, and said, you know what I'm saying, when most niggas came and gave clarity and showed charity to the motherfucking game and glorified this shit, you know what I mean, better. Like, I'm just being 100. So many want the position, so many want to be a blessing, but the truth is, you know what I mean? They don't have the mental capabilities to do it. They don't have that type of character. See, I really love the game. And even when she got out of bounds, because even when she got with him, she got out of pocket. She called me. She wanted to come back. But because I was loving what he was doing with that bitch, and I wasn't where I am today at that time, mentally or financially, I liked the fact that he had set up there, you understand me? He had got put the bitch in a nice little crib, you know what I'm saying? He had did that, you know what I mean? In a short time, man, you know what I mean? He was pimping the mud out that bitch, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, nah, you just in your feelings right now, you know what I mean? You just in your emotions, bitch, you know what I mean? You ain't gonna treat me like Rebound the P, you know what I mean? And call me just because you got a little funky ass, little funky little racks over there and shit like that, you know what I mean? Now, because it is pimping, when your partner's broad, get out of bounds and shit like that, if he really your partner, if you fuck with him, because me and this nigga really fuck with each other now. We chop it up about bitches all the time. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got actual love for this nigga. And that's why I be upset. Like, if you go to that video that I spoke on Snooki with, if you go to the comment section, everybody wanted to kill me and throw me in hell when I said that I was blessed to be in the presence of pimps. And they could not understand that. They couldn't understand when I said a pimp is a man of character. They couldn't understand that because their square mentality couldn't allow them to. But what other man do you know that can lose his motherfucking woman and just be okay with it? Give basically every materialistic that the bra hold up for to the next man, and they shake hands like gentlemen and be friends for years. What other men who got that type of character? Who got that type of class? Who got that type of camaraderie nowadays in any lifestyle that's contrary to the law? Who but the pimping? You know what I mean? Dre spoke about this in a previous video. You know, they had it real because his generation was really like the last generation of the gentleman. But, you know what I mean? Who? It's still some today. Freezes like that. My nigga Trophy like that. Johnny Cash like that. I'm like that. But it's only a few, man. It's only a few niggas, man, that you could actually call and be like, hey, man. Hey, Sinful. Man, I mean, who knows? One of you niggas might be in the comment section right now. And after I end this video, you might sit up there and say, yeah, P, I was really waiting for you to sit up there, man. You did good, man. You know, man, I wanted to tell you, man, that uncommon information and inspiration that you had in the conversation with them young niggas tonight, man, hey, man, you really did your thing. But, hey, I wanted to let you know, man, yeah, that little young bitch that you sent, yeah, you remember that little cute bitch? There was, yeah, man. Yeah, about that. Yeah, man, she in good hands with All Stay Pimping tonight, man. You know, man, she fucking with some pimping right now, man. Yeah, I was just calling. Yeah, P, I ain't want to interrupt. I ain't want to put your business all in the comment section and let you know, man, that the bitch wanted to sit up there, man, and pay me, man. Yeah, it's all. If a nigga, one of you niggas might be giving me that phone call tonight, and you know what I'm going to do? Smile with my two dimples You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to be like, man, it is what it is. And I got to give him this shit. You know what I mean? That's just how it is with true gentlemen of the game. Those who are authentic and really in it. I ain't trying to kill this nigga over no bitch. Come on, man. You know, and it's not that I don't love her. I do love her. But at the same particular time, she stopped loving the game that is within me. Or it might be the will of the game for her to be with another man, for her to come to the realization or to have gratitude for my motherfucking Harvard University plan about this Pippin. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, just accept the will of the game, man. When you finally get them phone calls for you young peas, because you're going to get served. When you finally get your first phone call, man, smile. Smile, man. That's just, man, welcome to the game, man. And Johnny Cash would say, welcome to the game, man. Welcome to the game, man. You know what I mean? And after you get that phone call, chop it up with them. And not only chop it up with them, because not only did me and Special chop it up, but I gave him how the bitch, you know, was reaching for me, the places to take her to. You know what I mean? So you get your money. I told him, you know, times when she was disobedient. I told him the problems that he would have, you know what I'm saying, with the family. You know what I mean? I told him, you know what I mean, situation. I told him about the business on how to preside over this bride so he can get a longer run than me. And the reason why I gave him that is because I sincerely wanted to see the bride be pimped on accordingly to the game. I have no malice. I have no animosity within my heart. Only love for the game. I hope you guys live as long as you want and never want as long as you live, man. I'll probably be back later tonight, man. You know what I mean? Make sure you share this video. I want this video, man. I spoke about too many topics, man. And it was so much shit that was spoke up on. You got to share this video. Those that fuck with me, share this video up on Facebook. Share it everywhere. Share it on YouTube. You know what I mean? Post it on your channel. You know what I mean? And spread it, man. You know what I mean? It's all love. I love all y'all. I might come back later tonight, but I already got so many text messages. I got to sit up there and take care of my family, man. They probably going to be like, why are you on there acting like you a pimp? You know you're a motherfucking square. And I am. You know what I mean? This was all entertainment, man. But I hope you guys was entertained. I hope you obtained something for your brain. You know what I mean? Stay encouraged, man. What's to come is better than what's been. Take heed. 1.